I got you.
Okay, I hope everybody's awake. Try not to put you to sleep here. I'm going to get right into it. I'm going to talk kind of fast. We got a lot to go over. I'm going to hit some of the basics. Again, I'm Ricky Kuhn. I'm currently the head football coach for Dodge City Community College in Kansas. Just finished my first year. I spent the 5 years before that at a Division I FCS school, Southeast Missouri State University, and where we ran this defense also. So a lot of the film you're going to see today is from there. We call it the Bear defense. It's just the tight front stuff everybody's running. We base out of it. We're going to talk today primarily about the inside and outside linebacker run fits, the basics of those. And so we're going to buzz through this. And if you have any questions, we'd love to answer anything that you have. All right. So our bare front. Okay. So we play, depending on the surface area, generally to a two-man surface, we'll play a three technique with the tackles. Okay. To a three-man surface, whether he's on the ball or off the ball, we may play a four-eye depending on game plan for down blocks and obviously to protect the C-gap and some of those things. So it's all of our alignments are our game plan able, but we do base out of 303. Our nose is obviously head up in a zero. Our tackles are responsible for the B-gaps. Our nose is responsible for one of the A-gaps, okay? We don't do lag technique or any of that. I think it's a clinic term. We don't do that. We don't teach that. The nose's job is essentially to tee off on the center, try to dent the apex of the formation, which is the center, and never let the guard overtake him to either side. And then the inside linebackers will make him right, okay? Our inside linebackers, Mike's to the field, Will's to the boundary. We're a field and boundary-based defense. They're going to toeser at four. They're going to be in what we call B4s, nose in the B-gap, 4 yards deep, could be 5 yards deep, whatever you're comfortable with. Inside linebacker eye control, we're going to start 1-2. We're going to read the tandem in front of us. So we're going to go O-line to backfield so we can see pullers and those things. All right, our base run fit for our inside linebackers is what we call open A, cut back C. All right, here it is in a picture. Okay, so on the top box here, the back is away from the mic, so he's essentially going to most likely be the open A player. All right, so he's going to take whichever A gap the nose does not take. All right, and if the center wants to reach the nose, obviously, he's going to end up in the backside A gap, so the mic will have the front side A gap. That's why you don't really have to teach the lag technique by the nose, because it usually happens that way, okay? If I am away from the back, or excuse me, if I'm on the side of the back, all right, in that top box, the wheel is on the same side as the back, I'm more than likely going to be the cutback C player, all right? So that ball is going to jump cut back to me, all right? We're going to get into some film here. So number 5 is the mic. Number 51 is the wheel. The back's away from the wheel. He triggers into the A gap. Nose is on the backside A. 51 triggers play side A. Number 5 is the cutback C player. Okay, he's got cutback and he's got inside half quarterback. If the quarterback were to pull it, he's going to play inside half quarterback and vice in with the outside linebacker, who we'll talk about in a little bit. So 51 is open A. Number 5 is cutback C. All right, same thing. We get a nice open A here. Tandem split. He's going to go get it. Great open A rep. Okay, here we go. We got double teams. Got one-on-one on the nose. 51's going to fill open A. Our safety's going to come down and take the C-gap. If they attach a tight end, all right, so now they're attaching a tight end. All right, and that cup, he's on the side of the back on this cutback C. He has to fit inside the tight end into the C gap. So this is a great fit by number 51. Send it to the outside linebacker. All right, this is a great picture because what if there is no open A? All right, watch number 19 here on the right side inside linebacker. Okay, there is no open A, so he's not just going to run in there and bury himself. If there's no open A, just fall back to the football. All right, fall back to the ball. Really good job by number 19, not wasting himself. That's one reason we use a key step where they just kind of bounce in place. We don't try to get downhill too fast. It doesn't do you any good to go fast to the wrong place. So it's a fantastic job falling back. Okay, if we get pistol, all right, we're just going to vice the ball. Okay, obviously on the snap, it'll declare. And we just teach them to vice the ball cloudy and clear so they don't have to think too much. All right, so 5 and 8 here, we're going to try to vice this football. Obviously, number 5, if he's going to go inside this block like he does, needs to make the play, and he does. But 5 and 8 are essentially just going to vice the football now. It's a way to keep it easy versus pistol. All right, then we get into what we call our cheat alignment. Okay, so if they want to play, we call it a yo, a Y off the ball, an H-back, whatever you want to call it. Okay, and so when we get yos, our base rule is to cheat the yos. Okay, so if the inside backer's on the side of the yo, he's going to cheat to C. All right, and the backside inside linebacker is going to cheat to 0 right over the ball. And we do that mainly for lead zone. All right, if they go lead zone here, we're in the C. We're getting picked up in the A gap. All right, we used to put this wheel back here in the backside A, and we weren't getting to the play side fast enough. So now we put them right in a 0. All right. Their eyes are a little bit different now. Now, if I'm the Mike here, I'm on the side, I'm cheating to C. Now my tandem is the yo and the tackle. That's where my eye control is, front to back. Okay. If the yo stays, we stay. Stay in the C, stay in the A. All right. If he falls back, split zone, we fall back into bare fits. Okay, so let's see what he does here. So he stays, so we stay. It's a great clip of a lead zone here. This is why. So you see these inside linebackers moving with the motion. So we pick the play side guy up in the C and the backside guy up. Should be in the A. The 3 technique gets overtaken. So he just makes them right. It's a fantastic fit. He falls back. The yo falls back. So now they just fall back into open A, cutback C, base, bear run fits. It's really, really simple. He falls back, we fall back. All right, there's two things that override our base run fits, and that's path and pullers. Okay, path and pullers. So box A, if we get full flow up front, the back is shoulders are turned to the sideline. All right, the path is going to override our fit. We're now going to work lateral. Okay, we're going to try to stay a half hole ahead of the ball to the front side and a half hole behind the ball on the backside and vice him in. Okay. If we get a puller, all right, front side guy is going to box it. The backside guy is going to not overrun the football and spill the puller. Okay, so here we go. This is path. We get outside path here. This is, I guess, mid zone, you could call it. Great job by the backside inside linebacker. All right, if he were to just run down in there or fall back, this ball would rip. He does a fantastic job of tracking the football. And those two are essentially going to vice the ball just like they do in pistol. Really nice job by our Mike here. He's patient. He's not crossing over. He's in a great football position. He's staying behind the football. Backside guy, never overrun the football. Really, really nice. And what the bare front does, especially when you play 303, all right, is nobody blocks the dang inside linebackers. All right, those guys are back there, and our front three take on those front five, and those guys are pretty clean most of the time. All right. This is a great job by number six here. All right, it took us a while. We had to work on this. Okay. He's got to get outside of that and send it back to our backside linebacker, just like he does. Good fit by those guys. Okay, now we're going to get into pullers. A couple things. If my guard pulls, okay, I'm going to point out the puller, number one. Why do we point the puller? Because game film has no audio, all right? And so I got to tell my buddy, pull, pull, pull. When I hear pull, 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 I am downhill trying to strike something. Pull, pull, pull. 27 goes downhill to box it. Five is tracking the ball over the top. Gap adjusts fit. Bam, very nice. Okay, I really like this fit by number eight here because a lot of times if with inside linebackers, you talk about boxing and spilling and doing all those things, well, they'll run up in there and they'll kind of slow down to make sure they're fitting right. All right, we want them to play fast. All right, so wherever you fit, if you hit them on their side of the line of scrimmage, it's good for us. So it's a great job by eight here. He's downhill. He frags the puller. He's supposed to box him, all right, but the guy's wide. His shoulders are turned, so he just frags him. The backside backer gap adjusts fit, and we're great. Fantastic job. Five's downhill to box it. Three's over the top. Pull, pull, pull. Bam. Don't overrun the ball. So path and pullers are the two things that take us off of our base run fits. All right, midline. If you run a lot of bare front or tight front, at some point, they're going to read your B-gap guy. All right? And we probably spent at least 3 years studying this, okay? So what we settled on, the base way we play it, and we have change-ups, but the base way we play it is we're going to surf our tackle, okay? If he gets the divide, meaning tackle arcs and the guard goes away, he gets a divide. He's going to squeeze, and he's going to surf out to the outside shoulder of the quarterback. The inside linebacker is going to insert for the dive, okay? And we do that because we never knew what to do with this guy. All right. He got arc. He chased the dive. If he went outside, he was wrong. If he went inside, he was wrong. If he went outside, he was wrong. If he stayed there and got hit in the face, he was wrong. There was just never a clean look. And once we started to surf it, it looked clean. So the tackle's going to surf it for quarterback. The inside backer's going to go for the dive. Okay, so here you go. On the left-hand side here, we get divide. All right, the B-gap guy, he goes for the quarterback. The inside backer goes for the dive. It's a much cleaner fit. Same thing, there it is. So we got everything taken care of. Quarterback, dive. It's a fantastic way to fit it. That's our base way. Okay, that's just a quick run through of the inside linebacker run fits. Okay, we're now going to go to the outside linebacker run fits. Okay, two base alignments that we use for our outside linebackers. We have an apex alignment, obviously, where they're between number two and the end man on the line of scrimmage with depth. And then they're in the hip, which is essentially a five or a nine technique. Okay. So you see it here, the top picture. All right, they're both in the hip. All right, so they're going to be 1 yard outside the end man on the line of scrimmage. If the back is on my side, our eyes are actually on the back because they are carrying the box in pass. Okay, the back's away from me. My eyes are going to be on the near hip of the offensive lineman or the tight end, okay, and reading his block. If we're in the apex, all right, we're reading the mesh. We're reading the backfield. So with the running back on our side, all right, so running back's on our side here. He's going to key step. He doesn't have to go anywhere fast. All right, you see a lot of teams, they get this flash fake. This outside linebacker is 1, 2, 3 inside. They pull it and throw it. He has to redirect and sprint all the way back out here, so he's wasting a lot of movement. All right, our guys don't move. When the back's on their side, if they're meshing the football, he's not going to move. So if they pull it and they throw the RPO, we are that much closer to making a play on the perimeter. Okay, so we're looking here. Again, fantastic job. If they were to pull and throw this RPO, he would be in a good position to help. He's a non-conflict defender. He is not the flat player. So when the back is on his side, he does not have to be in a hurry. If the running back's away from us, now we're a little bit faster. Now we're a little bit faster. Okay, now if the ball meshes, I've got to go set the edge. I've got to go force the ball, which we'll talk about in a minute. So he's a little bit faster now with the back away from him. Now, some of these teams are now starting to do opposite side RPOs, so that's obviously a game plan deal. I don't know how many high schools are doing them. Some colleges are starting to do that stuff. It's a great job of going to set the edge here. So, again, with the running back away, we are much more aggressive. All right, we'll just touch on these real quick. If they want to reduce a split, all right, we could take the line. All right, so we can get a good force here. We can flatten out this blocker so the safety can replace. All right. If he's really tight, nasty tight, all right, we can go outside shoulder and set the edge outside of that guy. So those are just some of our split adjustments. We won't go a lot of in-depth into those. We'll move on. All right, outside linebacker rules versus the run. Okay, it's very, very simple. It's force, shuffle, fold. Run at you, we're going to force everything. We don't spill anything. Pullers, we force all pullers, and their job is to feed the box. Okay, if runs away, we're going to make two shuffle steps and clear the quarterback. If the quarterback keeps it, we got him. All right, if they hands it off, we're going to become a fold player. All right. So here's some force reps. Really good job by 32 on the left. Left outside linebacker setting an edge on the tight end. Feed the box. Quickest two ways you get beat on defense is, number one, you get outflanked. Number two, you get beat over the top. Good job here, setting that edge on the tight end. Feed the box. You got a lot of people inside of you, not a lot of people outside of you. Feed the box. Okay, now he's going to force it on a fullback. He's going to kick out. He's going to force the kick. Bam. Force it inside. Feed the box. All right, now plays away. Two shuffle steps. Don't go too far because you got a fallback inside linebacker. So you don't have to get way down in here. You got a guy falling back to the ball. Shuffle, shuffle. If the quarterback keeps it, you got him. Shuffle, shuffle. If he keeps it, you got him. If he hands it, you add in. Again, we tell him two shuffle steps. It's a really important coaching point. Because of the fallback linebacker, you don't want them getting too tight in there. All right, now the fold. This fold, anytime you can gain overlap in your defense, it's very, very good for the run. All right, so you're going to see here, we're gaining overlap. Shuffle, shuffle. Quarterback doesn't have it. I'm going to fold. If he doesn't fold, this is a touchdown. Gaining overlap in your defense. So it might go for five or six, but it's not going to pop for a touchdown. Same thing here. All right, looking here. All right, he folds. If he's out of the picture, this thing is ripping and still running. So that fold player is really, really, really important. So this fold player made the play on the backside all the way on the, damn near on the perimeter. All right, so those are the base outside backer run fits. All right, I know I went fast. I try to go through a lot of clips fast. Here's my information, email, phone number, Twitter. Would love to answer any questions that you have. We'll share, if you're a high school guy, we'll share anything we can with you to help you out. So I appreciate you guys' time tonight. That's all I got. If people want to stay and ask questions, I'll answer them. I appreciate everybody's time.
You've got two questions in the chat. So the first one is, who's your flat player when you're playing zone?
It depends. We're generally we're a pattern match team, so it's generally the corner. Depending on the routes, we're a two read team, palms, whatever you want to call it.
Okay. And the second one says, does the surf technique take your three tech too far away from his normal reaction to down, and isn't it tough for him to read both the guard and tackle, or is it just game plan for a certain team?
No, I'm a D line guy for 18 years. If you're a D lineman and I can't see two big people 2 feet apart, then it's tough. So we do have to have some peripheral vision. And what we talk about is pressure, no pressure. That guard inside releases, and I don't get any pressure from the tackle, something's wrong. If nobody blocks me, something's wrong. Okay, so and what we tell them is if you've gotten vertical, you got a good get off and you got vertical, that's fine. Just go to the upfield shoulder of the quarterback. Okay, but it does take some repetition. We do a lot of individual. We do pods. If you're playing a team that's going to do it, yes, it is a lot of game plan recognition work with it.
All right. That was it. Thanks, Coach. We appreciate you coming on.
Yep. Thank you.